What can people who love the first season expect overall from this next batch of episode and the continuation of this journey?
Well, I will say I'm looking forward to seeing it as much as everyone else because I haven't actually seen Series 2 yet. So watching Episode 1 today will be fun. In general, I would say one of the things that a lot of people said to me about Series 1 in the early stages were there were a lot of characters to kind of be introduced to, get used to, fall in line with, learn not only their dynamics with each other but also their backstories. And so there was a lot going on, and I think once people really got to grips with who they were and how they were with each other, they really started to sort of settle in and deepen their likening of the show. And I think what Series 2 were able to do is keep those dynamics. We no longer have as many introductions to make. We can take what we now know and launch them sort of further into chaos, which Stephen has done brilliantly with the sort of the plotting of the, you know, the sort of crime elements and what they're involved in, but not losing any of the relationship dynamics and the sort of inward struggles that they're all facing as well. So I think bigger and better and, you know.
In terms of your character specifically, like all the characters in the show, I think when we're very first initially introduced to him, he seems to be a readily understood cliche, and rapidly that becomes clear not to be the case. What are you most excited about getting to develop that character further and keep living with him for just a little bit longer at least?
Yeah, I mean, I think one of the big sort of, aspects of the show was about stereotypes and that we do judge at face value. And this was a real example, I think, for Stephen to sort of peel back some of those layers, not only show that everyone has a story, but also put those sort of diverse types together and see how they in turn sort of affect each other. It's interesting with John because I obviously had the benefit of reading all the scripts. I knew the entire arc through Series 1 and 2. And for me, it was always the thing that drew me most to him and that I sort of fell in love with was this sort of almost sort of unrequited love aspect of a grown man who just wanted a hug from his father. And he was sort of, to me, one of those people who goes through life picking many, many small fights because he hasn't sort of resolved the major fight within himself. That was really interesting to me. So that sort of human aspect was the thing that for me was really fun to play with, and in Season 2 really fun to sort of dig deeper with that relationship with his father.
Seems unfair to say when he's standing within earshot, but Mr. Stephen Merchant behind you, obviously the creative force behind the show and a presence on screen as well. Can you talk a little bit about what makes him quite a special storyteller?
I think it's sort of rare that you get to work on a piece that really genuinely has something to say and really makes great effort to do so in such an entertaining way. It's not an easy task. And I think we're very much living in a world at the moment where we are actively unlearning, relearning a lot of things about us and the world. And we can only do that through openness and discussion and really listening. And I think what Stephen has been able to sort of capture is a real invitation in part to some part of that conversation. And it's very easy to sort of talk about work and say that things are you know, important and have something to say. In this case, I think it was never more true that this is, you know, he's saying some quite important stuff and he's inviting conversation from it. And I think that is something that I, for me, feel very privileged to, you know, be a part of that storytelling.